My name is Jack. I'm a second year economics student at UCC, and today I've been given the opportunity to discuss with you today the impact of the central bank's monetary policy on key economic variables in the Netherlands. Before I go into that, I want to discuss with you first about what I intend to discuss in this presentation. I'll discuss the background on the central bank, I'll discuss monetary policy and objectives, I'll discuss data from 2007 to 2017, DNP projections to 2019, as well as the effects on key economic variables such as inflation, unemployment, GDP, of standard and non-standard monetary instruments, and whether or not they worked, and if they didn't work, why not. The Nederlandse Bank is the name of the central bank in the Netherlands. It joined the Eurosystem in 1999, and the Eurosystem being the monetary authority of the Netherlands. Price stability is obviously is one of the key objectives of the Eurosystem. It's essential for economic growth and job creation. This is done through the use of monetary policies. The mission and task of the DNB is aligned with that of the ECB and the Eurosystem. The specific target of the Eurosystem's monetary policy is to maintain annual inflation at close to but below 2% over the medium term. There are standard and non-standard monetary policy mechanisms that can be applied. The standard are open market operations, minimum reserve requirements, and standing facilities. Open market operations being the day-to-day runnings of the business, of the bank even. Minimum reserve requirements being the minimum amount which the bank are required to have in their reserves not to be loaned out to people, and standing facilities then being the overnight running of the bank. Non-standard mechanisms then would be asset purchasing or quantitative easing, forward guidance, or negative interest rates. The primary tool used by the Eurosystem to manage price stability is the interest rates applied in the OMO, which is a classical Keynesian theory, who believed that monetary and fiscal policies were both essential to kickstart an economy, unlike his friend Hayek. However, the Eurosystem introduced a non-standard mechanism in March 2015 in the form of asset purchasing. This involved a commitment to purchase assets to value between 60 billion and 80 billion per month up until December 2017. Here we see the relationship between interest rates and inflation between the years 2017 and 2007 and 2016. The blue line here is the interest rates over the period. We can see them going from high rate in 2008 to a relatively low rate to zero even in 2016. But we can see from the inflation line that between the years 2011 and 2013, they were above the ideal 2% mark. And it falls down towards zero, which is quite problematic. As you can see from this, the monetary policy did not have the desired effect. Why might that be? There's two possible reasons, really. There's the fact that existing losses coming out of a economic downturn like that, the people have incurred losses, which makes them quite unlikely to be spending money or pumping any form of money into the economy. And as well as that, even if they recover from those losses, their confidence has been shook, so they'd be less inclined to spend money. Until the asset, then in 2015, the asset purchase program came out, which changed the DNB's projections entirely. We can see that in 2019, their forecasted inflation is at 1.4%, which is a lot closer to the recommended 2% mark. So it is fair to say that after all this, that the standard monetary policy did not have its desired effect, or didn't achieve its goals, until the asset purchase program came in 2015. As well as examining those economic variables, unemployment is another one worth note. We can see it following a similar enough trend. We see from the year 2007 to 2014, it follows a fairly consistent rate of increase, even from 3% in around 3% to up over 7% until 2015, when we see it dropping. This is no doubt due to the asset purchase program. As well as that, we see GDP, which is another important economic variable, and we see that fluctuating greatly from 2007 up to 2014. But once the asset purchase program came in 2015, we see consistent growth. In 2019 as well, the DNB forecasted approximately 2% growth per annum, which is quite good. So to conclude, standard monetary policy did not achieve its intended goals. I touched on existing losses and confidence already as being one of the main reasons why this may have been the case. But it was really the asset purchase program in what revived that economy. And I think that alone is the main reason. That is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for listening.